We live on an island with cliffs that rise like cathedrals from the shoreline. And we have sandy beaches spread as flat as a pool table. We have white-knuckled surfing and great places to enjoy time on the water. We share a coastline for sailors, fishermen, and paddleboarders to enjoy. And if you prefer to stay on land, there are fabulous places to walk and explore. Yet nothing ever stays the same, and our coastline is the product of hundreds of millions of years of painfully slow erosion. Great continents have collided, mountain ranges have risen, volcanoes have erupted, and dinosaurs have roamed the land. So what I've tried to do with this book is to bring together all the different factors at play. I've looked at the rocks and the fossils you can find from the past, and the way in which the wind, the rain, waves and currents shape the coastline in the present. And I'll show you a really good example. This is the Old Man of Hoy in the Orkneys. It's the tallest sea stack in the country. But it didn't always look like this. A watercolour painted 200 years ago shows it was wider, taller, and had a sea arch at its base. In 200 years, relentless wave action has eroded away the sea stack to what it is today, and the whole rock formation is expected to collapse at any time. This is just one of many illustrated examples I use in the book to open a window on how our coastline has been formed. And there are many, many more. Even the hardest rocks of all will, in time, be eroded by the sea and broken down to boulders, pebbles, and eventually sand. As a result, we have miles of magnificent beaches backed by large areas of sand dunes. These areas are important for sea defence, but they're also a fragile environment which needs to be looked after. And all around our coastline are estuaries, offering a quiet refuge from the unforgiving ocean. These muds and sands create a nursery for young fish to mature before they face an uncertain life in the open ocean. And these muddy wetlands also form important habitats for coastal birds. All these sites are listed at the end of my book. The story of our eroding shoreline is a fascinating one, and it's resulted in what's arguably the most diverse and varied coastline anywhere in the world.